He was not as close to Vernon, his father, as by any means as he was his mother. But his mother, you know, she held his hand and took him to church and took him to school, walked him to school when he was a child. Wow. Those things he never forgot. She was always there for him when he needed her. And it's just something he never forgot, and, you know, he never got over her death.
Not only were they close as a family, they lived in close quarters. Elvis spent his first years in this two-room house on the poor side of Tupelo.
The house was 30 by 15, I believe, just a bedroom and a kitchen. Elvis and his parents, late in the afternoon, sitting on the porch, they would sing, and other members of the family would come over and sing. And I'm going to be perfectly honest and candid with you. We would see him around town, see him at gospel singing. But you remember back in those days, like, you aren't, well, now I'm not talking about the Elvis Presley that you see now with a rhinestone cage. That was Gladys and Vernon's kid.